I now call upon Mr. Rashmibhai Jhaveri to present his response to Dr. Zakir Naik. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Rashmibhai Jhaveri.
First of all, I really thank Dr. Zakir Naik for giving me the choice whether I would like to still remain a vegetarian or non-vegetarian. Thank you very much. I would request Mr. Coordinator that would you like to have the rebuttal or my comments now, or shall we have?
No.
Because after all, you know, this is...
No. Now it's better, you know, we'll...
Let's have some question part. Answer, if you think.
Question answer we have in the third session. We have three-part session. Yes, Mr. Jhaveri, you can continue.
Now, we are totally at the command of the coordinator, so I will obey.
As decided, you know, the same format we keep.
I will obey.
I will not allow Dr. Zakir also to change the format.
Now,
I'll object.
First thing that I will say, it's not a question of whether one is logical or illogical, and it's not a question of the choice that one makes. As I said in my talk earlier, everything is relative. And you have to understand this topic from that perspective. Now, one thing that I will really strongly object with respect to Dr. Zakir's, that not a single religion prohibits non-veg. I am expert, I can say, because I am a student. I have done MA in Jainology. I can say from my religious point of view that Lord Mahavir and our all 24 Tithankaras very vehemently prohibited non-veg food. I have already given you some quotations. You see, mainly arguments of Dr. Dean Ornish is based on the fact that non-veg food contains excessive protein, cholesterol, and saturated fat. So that is why he said that for healthy and peaceful living, you must have non-veg veg diet. Now, he said that plant has also got life. No, it is not only proved by Dr. Jagdish Chandra Bose, but even our Lord Mahavir, he stated 2,500 years ago that not only plant, air, water, fire, minerals of the earth, they all have life. He has not said that you are allowed to kill this life and maintain yourself. But he was a practical Tirthankara. So he said that those who cannot renounce this world and become Jain Muni. You know, Jain Munis, they don't even kill plant vegetation or even other living beings for their food. They bake the food which is cooked in our house. We'll not go into that controversy that even you kill it and then give them. That's a separate story. But the teachings of Mahavir are very clear that you shall not harm any living being, whether animate or inanimate. Now, because of certain constraint for those people who cannot renounce the world, he has said that at least you can avoid essential killing. He has said that even if you, when you have food made out of plant, it is violence, it is hinsa, but it is necessary. So what I prohibit is unnecessary killing. Friends, this is a very sharp distinction, but very important distinction we should make, that if the alternative is available, we should not go for that alternative which compels us to kill and eat our own fellow creatures. Another thing, sir. He said, plants. In my talk, I stated about plant food, and he said that even a lizard can grow tail. That's the only exception. The plants, you pluck fruits, they will give you more fruits. You cut their branches, more branches will grow. See, there is no end to such argument. So let us restrict our argument to this. About medical science, and he rightly stated that medically also he has given certain things. I have also stated. Now, it is for the enlightened audience to decide whether the scientific facts that I have given are correct or he has given. It's okay. It's a question of argument. Now, he has conveniently forgotten. Please excuse me, I'm telling because I'm trying to rebut your things. The psychological aspect. When we consume animal food, we also inherit certain animal instincts. What have you to say? Please, in your rebuttal, you can say that. Now, doctors also, most of the doctors prescribe raw vegetable. Now, coming to cooking, most of the doctors prescribe raw vegetables for healthy diet. Only that food or cereals which will not be proper for a human being to consume raw, that only can be cooked. But as far as possible, and in our Indian Vegetarian Congress, we always, whenever we have a meeting, we have most of the food raw, uncooked, and that is more healthy, according to us. About the books, these books were not given by me to Dr. Nayak, and it was given by my friend, Mr. Salecha, who approached me. That's okay, it's nothing very important. Now, I will tell you one thing, that you cannot alter the truth by just loud applause. Okay. If you are impressed by my argument, you may applaud me. Or if you are impressed by the other argument, you can applaud that. But I firmly believe that just because some arguments are appealing to you and you applaud them loudly will not alter the truth. And I have referred to about one book, Dr. Deepak Chopra. He has also written many books. He is also a physician, practicing physician, like Dr. Dean Ornish. He has also conducted researches. And he has come out with a theory that your food will have a terrific effect on your impulses and urges, your physical development, psychological development, and emotional development. You know, most of the psychological and emotional distortions are because of the flesh food that one eats, and that is why it is prohibited. It is totally illogical to say that by eating animals, you are helping vegetarians. We should not worry about the animal population because nature is quite capable of taking care. Why? Because we are rearing more animals for killing. That is why if we are not doing it, look at the jungle. Everywhere the natural cycle is there. Balancing will take care of itself. Nobody has to worry about it. Now, as per the history that Mr. Trivedi also referred, and also Dr. Jakir. Now, I will tell from Jain historical point of view that in our Jain scriptures, it is mentioned very clearly that those persons who were living in prehistoric stage, they lived under a tree and they were sufficiently provided by trees, did not have to go for any killing. Friends, I am of course given more time, but I really personally feel that let's not have a sort of dialogue or arguments between. I would like very much the audience to participate and have more time for question and answer. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Zaveri. We have more. It's taking 5 minutes left. Now I call upon Dr. Zak to present a response to Mr. Rashmi Bhai Zaveri for 15 minutes only.
Alhamdulillah, wa salam ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd, a'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Wa qul ja'a batil. Inna la batila kana zahuk. Min al-Quran ma huwa shifaa'un wa rahmatul mu'minin. Zalimin illa khasara. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri. Uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. Respected people on the dais, elders and my brothers and sisters, welcome once again, all of you. Assalamu alaikum. May peace, mercy, and blessings be on all of you. Conveniently forgotten anything. I spoke maybe half a minute more. So, how can you say I conveniently? If you give me even 5 hours more, you're willing to stay. You are the person who kept time restrictions. You know, let's do bargain for 50 minutes. I would 2 hours, even full day, because I'm a marathon speaker. I'm a non-vegetarian. that I said no religion prohibits non-vegetarian. I said no major religion. It's being recorded. No major religion. Jainism is not a major religion. Books you gave me. You gave certain books. Only 0.4% of India. Less than 1%. In India, leave aside the question. Negligible. Clear cut my statement regarding the argument on. But the coordinator won't give me permission. I'm restricted to Islam. I can reply even on Jainism. I'm a student of compassion.
Excuse me, sir. You can't interfere speaking.
Well, they're saying I did not say. You will see the video cassette. There is no single major religion bans or prohibits food in general. Video cassette.
Can ask your question in question time.
Don't get irritated. The diet. Don't get it. Brother Rashmi Bhai Zaveri said, sir, whether you get animals. I said in my lecture, I think you didn't hear. Peaceful animals like goat, sheep. And therefore, when I came, started, said, peace be on all of you. Further, he said, Dr. Dean Ornish, if his book heard by any authentic book, not just that answer already gave by Dr. Jarvis, even scientists and medical are not immune to the thinking of the vegetarians. Immune. It's not a medical book. He may have a book. I am very clear in my words. And Dean, whatever his name is, may be very famous. I don't know. First time. I yet ask him to prove is referred as a textbook, a text medical book. You know, that shows authenticity. Don't worry about the cattle. Nature will take care. It is you all who are so much worrying. Nature made them in such a way, the moment you kill them, they will again come. God is the creator. Allah, if we kill lion, tiger, they will become extinct. Oh, we cannot have their food. The cattle can have. God has made them that way. Follow the instruction of God, they will be overpowered. And regarding cutting plants, what he said, to say that if you have plants, the mother is. So in that way, the offspring of the cow, of the goat, the calves. Can we cut them? Yes. The mother is yet alive. The cow is yet alive. And when the offspring becomes a mother, you can also kill the mother. So even if I agree with this logic, the in the animals, more than the plants, if I agree with his logic. Furthermore, I said that best is prevention is better than cure. I agree with Anish when he says that prevention diet is helpful for certain diseases. Even I advise, where I said no. But the topic is not healthier. But making a statement, it is banned for human beings. I challenge any authentic medical, not books, whether given by Russia Foundation or Indian Congress, whatever it is, these books are things which are ill-tested, unproved. There is a method of prevention better than cure which will answer more of your questions. The Islamic method is there, prevention better than cure. When we slaughter the animal, we do the zabiha. We cut the throat and the windpipe and the vessels of the neck without damaging the spinal cord. Otherwise, the nerve going to the heart may get severe, there may be cardiac arrest. When the spinal cord is damaged and the vessels of the neck are slit open along the throat and the windpipe, the heart is pumping, most of the blood flows out of the body. It is a very good media of germ and bacteria. If you slaughter the animal in this way, most of the disease transmitted by blood, many which you named, can be eliminated, can be prevented. The meat fresh for a longer time if it's sorted with the Islamic method. And people say, oh, it's so merciless. Oh, you all are so mercilessly killing. It dies of pain. When we shorten the blood, when we cut the blood vessels of the neck, the blood supply going to the nerve, which is responsible for pain, is severed. So the animal does not feel pain. The animal kicks and writhes. You know why? Due to the gush of flow. The animal doesn't feel pain. It is contracting and relaxing because there's lack of blood in that part of the body. The animal does not die of pain. It dies a painless death. Painless. Painless. We eliminate most of the disease transmitted by blood. Secondly, there are many countries in the world and many people who raise animals. They give them hormones. And one was mentioned by Mr. Zaveri, the name. It's called as DES, diacylglycerol. It's a hormone injected to cattle so that they become fat and you get more money for flesh. This is haram in Islam. Carcinogenic hormone. If ingested in animal, even if you slaughter by the zabiya method, it is yet haram. It is zabiya but not halal. It is zabiya and haram. If the cattle are injected with hormones, you are not allowed to have those hormones. Neither are we allowed to have cows which are fed with non-veg. Because the Prophet said, any animal that is fed with non-veg, it is prohibited for you. After that, if you take care of hygienic conditions and cook the meat very well, most of the diseases which Mr. Zaveri spoke, or not all, most of them will be eliminated. And in the non-veg flesh food, the most dangerous, which is commonly eaten, is pork. It has more than 70 different diseases which you can get if you ingest pork. More than 70 different diseases. And one of them is ischemic heart disease, which he spoke about. Because pork has more of fat-building material than muscle-building material, it gets deposited on the walls of the vessels, causing atherosclerosis, hypertension, etc. That's the reason in the Quran, no less than 4 different places, in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 173, in Surah Maidah, chapter number 5, verse number 3, in Surah Anam, chapter number 6, verse number 145, and Surah Nail, chapter number 16, verse number 115, it says, "Hurrimat alaykumul maytutu waddamu walahmul khinzir, wama uhilla li ghairillahi." Forbidden for you for food are dead meat, blood, the flesh of swine, and any food on which any name besides God's name has been invoked. It's haram. So we abstain from it, and we prevent several diseases of non-veg. Quran says in Surah Taha, chapter number 20, verse number 81, "Eat of the food we have provided for you in sustenance, but commit no excesses therein." Most of the diseases, what Mr. Rashmi Bhai Zaveri spoke about, is due to excessive eating. Even if you eat excessive veg food, you will have many diseases. I will not say, don't have veg food. I'm a doctor. I'm not an ideological, neither a fanatic non-vegetarian. So if you prevent eating in excess, most of the disease will be prevented. If you follow the Islamic guidelines, slaughter in the Islamic method, remove the blood, don't give hormones, cook the food very well, hygienic conditions, avoid pork, don't eat in excess, most of the disease can be prevented. It answers most of his arguments. Few are yet remaining. If time permits or in question answer time, if you ask, I will reply. Do you know that talking about healthy food, talking about all research and experiments, I'll talk something which is a fact. According to Dr. William, again, very famous person, Dr. William, he says that vegetarian food extends the life of a human being for more than 6 years. If you have veg food, as compared to non-veg food, you live 6 years longer. Again, hypothesis. Hypothesis. If you analyze, a data was collected about all the people who lived above 100 years from 1932 to 1952. And on this data, a person by the name of O. Sijares, he wrote a book, Living to be 100, 1,200 people who did and why they did it. Everything is mentioned. In it, even diet is mentioned. Do you know out of 1,200 people, how many were vegetarian? How many? Guess. 1,000. Four. Four. This survey wasn't done to prove veg food or non-veg food. It was done for other reasons, but even the diet was mentioned. It's a fact. It's not a research. It's a fact. Out of 1,200 people who lived in the span of 20 years, over 100 years, only 4 were vegetarian. You know alcohol? Alcohol alone, it is a veg diet or not? Alcohol is veg or non-veg? Veg, from juices of fruits. And the disease that are caused by alcohol alone is more than all the non-veg disease put together. One vegetable diet. So just for alcohol, I cannot say that all vegetable foods should be banned. Today, scientists, and he'll agree, it's mentioned in these books also, the cause of maximum death in the world today is alcohol, number one. So I don't ban all veg food. What do I say? As Quran says, Surah Maida, chapter number 5, verse number 90. Ya yuladin amanu, innamal khamru al maisuru, wa anzabu al aslamu, rishtum minam al shaitan, fashtanibu lalakum tuflihun. That, oh, you believe? Verily, intoxicants and gambling and idol worship and dedication of stones and divination of arrows, these are Satan's handiwork. Abstain from it that you may prosper. Alcohol is a Satan's handiwork. Abstain from it. I only prohibit alcohol, not all veg food. And smoking. Second greatest cause of death in the world. Veg or non-veg? Veg. Can you prevent the alcoholic disease? Only way you can prevent is defermented. It ceases to be alcohol. Can you prevent smoking disease? Don't have tobacco. Only option is prohibition. If there is no prevention, then comes the question of prohibition. So alcohol is prohibited. There are more than 400 fatwas by Islamic scholars. Smoking is prohibited because there's no prevention. You know Kesari Dal? Kesari Dal? Indian government has banned it. It causes spastic paraplegia, staple food of Northwest Indians. Banned. Why? It causes death also. Spastic paraplegia. Alcohol. Many countries have banned, including Saudi Arabia, including states in India have banned it. Smoking in Singapore is banned in public places, in government places, in public transport. Kesari Dal banned by India. If there's no prevention, then you can ban it. I do not know of a single government that has banned all non-veg food in general. Not a single. Yes, few non-veg food, like pork, Saudi Arabia has banned. There's no prevention, ban it. If there's no prevention, then you prohibit it. And the debate was not which is better, which is healthier, veg or non-veg. The debate was, is non-veg food permitted or prohibited? I gave a list of more than 20 points. So I can very well say that Mr. Rashmi Bhai Zaveri conveniently stopped this talk 5 minutes before, not to answer these things. If you give me 1 hour more, I will continue speaking. Wild berries, they're poisonous. Strychnine, vegetable food, they're poisonous. Datura, poisonous. What's the solution? Don't have it. You know, water. Water has so many diseases transmitted. Cholera, paratyphoid, typhoid. It causes amoebiasis, giardiasis, roundworm, pinworm, vile hepatitis. I can go on talking. Only by water. What do you do? Do you ban water? You prevent it. You purify the water. The disease will be prevented. You know, milk. Milk has so many diseases. Shigella, cholera, paratyphoid, typhoid, tuberculosis, salmonellosis, brucellosis. I can go on listing. What do you do? Do you ban milk? What do? You pasteurize it. You don't ban it. You don't prohibit it. It's unmedical. Whether milk is non-veg or veg is a debatable topic. I won't argue on that. So if you cannot prevent the disease, then do you prohibit it? I have given various reasons, which Mr. Rashmi Bhai Zaveri hasn't replied. There's not a single government who has banned non-veg food in general. There's not a single major religion which has banned non-veg food in general. Therefore, I say that non-veg food is permitted, not prohibited. If I've heard the feelings of any vegetarians while giving the replies to the speaker, I sincerely apologize from the bottom of my heart. I would like to end the talk by giving the quotation of the glorious Quran from Surah Isra, chapter number 17, verse number 81, which says, وَقُلْ جَعَ الْحَقُّ وَزَاكَ الْبَاطِلِ إِنَّ الْبَاطِلَ كَانَ زَهُكَ. When truth is heard against falsehood, falsehood perishes. For falsehood is by its nature bound to perish. وَآخْرُ دَعْوَانَ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ.
Now we begin the open question and answer session. To extract maximum benefit in the limited time that we have available in the question and answer session, we expect the following rules to be observed. Your question should be on the topic only, that is non-vegetarian food permitted or prohibited for a human being? Questions out of the topic will not be permitted. Kindly state your question briefly and to the point. This is not a lecture time, neither a cross-question time for the questioners. I repeat, kindly state your question briefly and to the point. This is not a lecture time, neither a counter question time for the questioners. Mr. Zaveri and Dr. Zakir should answer comprehensively, and each answer should not exceed 5 minutes. 4 mics have been provided in the auditorium, 2 next to the stage for the gents, and 2 in the rear central aisle for the ladies. If you wish to put a question to Mr. Zaveri, kindly queue up behind the mic with the name clip, question for Mr. Zaveri, similarly so in the ladies. And if you wish to put a question to Dr. Zakir, kindly queue up behind the mic with the name clip, question for Dr. Zakir. Only one question at a time may be asked. For your second question, you would have to go right at the back of the queue again and await your second chance. Written questions on slip papers, which are available from the volunteers in the aisles, would be given secondary preference if time permits. On your slip where you're putting your question, kindly tick or write to whom your question is addressed, Mr. Zaveri or Dr. Zakir, or it might be put aside. Kindly state your name and profession before putting forward your question so that the speakers would be in a better position to answer you. We would allow one question on each of the mics in a clockwise rotation, alternately addressed to each speaker. May we have the first question from the mic on my left? So we have first gents, ladies two, then gents again. Yes, brother, we can have the first question from you. That's for Mr. Zaveri.
Yeah.
Yes.
Respected chief guest and Mr. Zaveri, my question is, you have spoken non-vegetarian is prohibited from various angles, and you have spoken about your Lord Mahavir. Mahavir advised that killing animals and living happy at the expenses of others is prohibited. Now please explain to me, did Mahavir say that can you eat vegetarian in the sense, I mean, Mahavir never go and cut trees and have vegetable foods. He was always sitting under the tree, and the food which he has eaten is mostly fruits which has fallen from the tree. He was not plucking up the fruits and ate. So please explain to me, because you have spoken on the subject of this, vegetarian, non-vegetarian is prohibited for the thing. And please explain to me what is the Jain view, because your idea is the what okay. Mahavir said. What
please,
Mahavir said.
I have understood your question.
Yeah,
I will reply. See, what Lord Mahavir stated that even plant has got life, and he says that even eating vegetable food is, as per the Jain scriptures, is prohibited for Jain Muni. But because of constraint, everybody cannot become a Jain Muni. That is why he said that at least the unnecessary killing of animals should be avoided. He never said that eating of plant food is allowed even for Jain Munis.
Yes, sister. Question for Dr. Zakir.
Assalamu alaikum, Brother Zakir. I'm Humaima here. I have a question. There are various pamphlets distributed by a vegetarian society quoting the Quran from Surah Hajj that it is not the meat nor the blood that reaches Allah, but your piety that reaches Him, thus proving that Islam prohibits killing of animals for fowl. There are many quotations from Quran and Hadith showing concern for animals.
I would like to thank the sister. She has asked a very fundamental question, that there are certain pamphlets distributed by organizations proving from the Quran and Hadith that non-veg food a Muslim should not have, it is prohibited. And this was the initiation of this debate. I didn't touch on it because, you know, they told me to keep out of religion. But since it's a question, I'm compelled to answer. This was a pamphlet that the president of Rusha Foundation, Mr. Dhandak Salesha, he gave, and how this debate was initiated. He gave this pamphlet quoting from the Quran. I'll just give also reference. The reference is a bit wrong out there, but I don't catch on to the reference. He's quoting a verse from Surah Hajj, chapter 22, verse number 37, which says that it is not their meat nor their blood which reaches Allah, which reaches God, but it is your piety that reaches Him. And I agree with that totally. It's indicating that Islam is not like certain other religions which believe that Almighty God requires blood and meat to survive. It's saying that when you sacrifice, blood doesn't reach God, meat doesn't reach God. It is your intention. It is the righteousness. It's the piety with which you sacrifice. Allah considers that piety. That is the reason when we sacrifice in Eid al-Zuha, minimum one-third portion of that animal has to be given compulsory to the poor people. One-third can be given to friends and relatives. And maximum one-third you can keep for personal use. There is no part kept for Almighty God. Because Quran says in Surah An'am chapter 6, verse 14, that He feedeth everyone but does not require to be fed. Allah Almighty God feeds everyone. He doesn't require to be fed. This verse is clear that when you sacrifice, Allah sees your intention. He doesn't require blood and meat of the animal. There's one more quotation. There are various. It will take me 1 hour to reply to all. I'll just pick up the second quotation of Quran, the two Quranic quotation. It says in Surah Baqarah chapter 2, verse number 205, that when they turn away, they create mischief through the land by destroying crops and cattle. Allah loves not those who make mischief. After giving this quotation, below it's mentioned that therefore you should not have non-veg. The interpretation. The Arabic word used is nasal, which some have translated as cattle. It actually means progeny. But irrespective whether nasal you translate as cattle or progeny, if you read the context, those people who create mischief throughout the world by destroying crops and cattle or progeny, not slaughtering for food, destroying for creating mischief. Allah does not like those who make mischief. So if you kill any animal, even the plant if you kill, for making mischief, Allah doesn't like. If you say this verse refers to not having for food, that means you should not even have the crops. If I agree with you, this verse refers not to have cattle, even crops is there. It is a very wrong way of argument. They don't do self-analysis. Crop is also mentioned there. If they say by this verse, non-veg is prohibited, even veg is prohibited, it is not. Neither non-veg is prohibited, neither veg is prohibited. Certain foods which Allah has prohibited is mentioned in the Quran. The others Allah says in Surah Baqarah chapter 2 verse 168, eat of the good food we have provided for you. Regarding animal concern. Yes, there are various hadith. If you read Sahih Bukhari volume number 3, hadith number 551, and Sahih Bukhari volume number 8, hadith number 38, it speaks about a man who gave water to a thirsty dog. And Prophet said, he'll be rewarded. So people asked, do you even have reward for giving water to a thirsty dog? The Prophet said, yes. For every kind act you do to the animal, you will be rewarded. Imagine in the days of ignorance, Yawmul Jahiliyah, 1400 years ago, where human beings were treated like animals, our beloved Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam spoke about animal rights. Prophet said, don't overload the animals. You know, today in India, two bullocks are supposed to also say that the cholesterol in the egg is not the major villain. It is the saturated fat in which you fry the egg, butter, ghee, lard, pork, which is the main villain. If you don't have this frying in ghee, butter, the less chances of having ischemic heart disease by egg. And today, amongst the population, two-thirds of the population are non-responders to cholesterol. The moment there's high intake of cholesterol, like taking egg, the liver immediately cuts its own production. And the level that reaches the blood is the same. There are one-third people who are to cholesterol. They have a problem. They should abstain from yolk of the egg. Otherwise, even if you have one or two eggs a day, you will not have heart diseases. And if you have it with bacon, with pork, then the problem. If you fry in ghee, you'll have a problem. If you fry in groundnut oil, you'll have a problem. Causing baldness. I don't want to give examples. Even if you check here, there are many people who are bald. There are great philosophers who are bald. I don't want to take their names. I don't want to hurt your feelings. So this thing is just a research which is based on illogical assumption. A research should be practical. And the associate factor for heart disease is also alcohol as well as smoking.
these two are also one of the associated causes for heart diseases. Yes, in America, heart diseases are more in non-veg because they have fats. Quran says don't have an excess, this problem will be solved. Secondly, the vegetarians of America, they are fluent. It's a woke to be a vegetarian because, you know, to buy veg food is expensive. If you turn Mercedes car, you have status. If you have veg food, it is status there. About 3 to 7% are vegetarian in America. Less than 1% are pure vegetarian. Less than 1%. Because they are fluent and they are rich, they take more care of hygiene. And many vegetarian ideologically also, like even Mr. Rashmi Zaveri may agree that alcohol is prohibited, smoking is prohibited. Because of associated factors, the case of heart disease in vegetarian is less. But anyone who has food which is rich in cholesterol or fat, irrespective whether it is veg or non-veg, he will have heart disease. To prevent it, follow the guidance in the Quran in Surah Taha, chapter number 20, verse number 81, that do not commit excesses. That reminds me of a story. In school we had learned that there was a religious priest who ate excessive food, and he had 64 laddus, and when he came back, his wife said, that why don't you have furan chutki, some digestive? So he says, Are baoli akal nahi banke che bachcho ki mata, agar churan chutki ke liye jagah hoti, to main do laddu aur na bhok leta.
Brother, the question is directed to Mr. Rashmi Zaveri. This is a book I've come across, which is named Meat Eating 100 Facts. Please, sir. This is not concerning
you may,
to you.
You may put your question saying one book writes like that rather than saying this person's book or that. You say this book states so and so, that would be acceptable.
Okay, here is a book from Jain publication. You being a Jain, I'm asking you a question. Which is, the name is Meat Eating 100 Facts, written by Dr. Nemi Chand. And it gives a cartoonic representation of meat-eating people, which I feel it's very insulting and, it's degrading, defaming. So I just want to ask you, in this Jains being tolerant, is it fair enough for Jains to publish such books which can hurt people's feeling? I mean, is this, it's mockery, Please answer.
Yes, the speaker would not like to answer to that. I give him the full right not to answer to the question which a speaker feels is
but
not
I'm
suitable.
Just asking about
we will allow the second question. Will the speaker?
The question of
okay,
being
the
tolerant.
Next question, please, for the he passes that answer. He
I'm
would not like to respond.
I'm
he
not does, satisfied.
See, the speakers have a right. See, the I would request the questioners not to get worried or agitated in any sort. The speakers have a full right not to respond, or if you feel your question is not right or not suitable for them, they have a right not to respond back. Kindly note, so put your question and frame it in such a way that it is not vulgar, neither derogatory. And yes, so it should not be derogatory to the speaker or to a particular faith. Put it in a factual manner. This is what stated. What is your opinion? Don't give your comment in a derogatory manner. Ask, what do you say about this? Yes, don't give your opinion. Let the speaker give their opinion on the subject. Yes, sister. Next question for Dr. Zakir.
Assalamu alaikum, brother. My name is Azra. I would like to ask, in a book promoting vegetarianism by Gopinath Agarwal, on page 15th and 16th, he says that the milk a cow gives in its lifetime can satisfy 90,000 persons at one time. But the same cow is killed for flesh can satisfy 1,000 persons at one time. The same applies for goat also. He says killing the goose that lays a golden egg daily is never a wise proposition. Do you agree with him?
Sister asked a question again from the same book. And I would like to make a clarification. Mr. Salech has books and said you can have more books. The letter is there if you want. And these books are available in various marketplaces. People are bound to buy, etc. That's right. Therefore, I'm telling, I'm requesting the people. That's right. That's right. The brothers asked, why am I repeating? Because all the arguments are mentioned here. These arguments, if it's not mentioned here, I wouldn't have repeated it.
Please, I think your tempers must be calm. What Mr. Zaveri said very correctly, book is written by somebody else. It is he who should try to defend the book. Mr. Jhamri doesn't want to defend the book. So let us forget the book and ask all questions which are pertaining to the talk.
Correct. And I agree with it. Mr. Zaveri read from books. He didn't do a research. He read books with speaking against non-vegetarian. He read books and he presented the fact. Either I accept it or I say the fact is wrong. I can't say because I didn't write the book, no one can ask me questions. That's illogical. If you ask me any questions pertaining to non-veg food, I either say the book is false or I say that it's illogical or it's logical. Why do you have to get irritated? It's a book promoting vegetarianism. If someone gets me a book against Islam, I will say that book is false.
Excuse me, I don't allow a debate between the audience and the speaker. The audience just put the question. The speaker can only answer the question. Don't get involved. I will not allow Dr. Zakir, neither Mr. Zaveri to get involved in any debate with the audience. This is not a debate time for the audience. Kindly note. You can continue with the answer.
I'm going to start with the answer. You can start the timing also. If I'm going to be interrupted every time, I want to give a complete answer. I would request the chairperson not to be biased towards one person only. If they're interrupting my answer, I have to be given time. And sister raised an argument, which is there not only in this book, even other books on internet. You go to the internet, the same argument is given. First thing is, that is milk veg or non-veg is a big question. There are vegetarians who say that milk is non-veg. This book. I'm not blaming the speaker. This book, again, says milk is non-veg. If you have milk, so many diseases. Other vegetarian foundations say, no, we are lacto-vegetarian, we have milk. Whether milk is non-veg or veg, my simple question is, if you don't want to hurt the animals, when you milk the animal, it causes severe pain. You know, artificial milking of animal causes pain. You ask a breastfeeding woman, certain times she has problems, and she has to extract milk artificially, it is so painful. So when you extract milk from the animal, it's painful. When you don't agree that animals are meant for food, how can you milk the animals, the cattle and the cow? It is so painful. It is nothing but robbing the animal. If you say the animal is not meant for food, and if you have the milk of that animal, you're robbing the milk which is meant for the offsprings, for the calves. And the example that was given, that a cow, on average, in a day gives 10 kgs of milk. Again, this book. If it's wrong, no problem. It's on the internet also. 10 kgs of milk in a day. In a month, 300 kgs. In a year, about 3,000 kgs. Do you calculate milk in kgs? In liters. Why in kgs? I don't know. Ask the author. And then further it says that 3,000 kgs of milk, it will feed 6,000 people. So in full lifetime, it will feed 90,000 people at one time. And the cow, if you kill, only 1,000 people. Which is better, 90,000 or 1,000? Why are you killing the goose that's laying the golden egg daily? It's not a wise proposition, and I agree with that. But the point to be noted is that no milkman will ever give a milking cow to the slaughterhouse. No slaughterhouse will ever purchase a milking cow because a milking cow is multiple times more expensive than a cow which has passed its age of milking. In Bombay, it costs 20 to 25,000 rupees milking cow. An old cow which has crossed the milking age cost only 3 to 5,000 rupees. So, what we do, we non-vegetarians, the cattle, we look after it till the time it gives milk. After it starts giving milk, we slaughter it. We take all the eggs of the goose. When it stops laying, we slaughter the goose for its flesh. Saab bhi mare aur lathi bhi na toote. Two birds with one stone. We are more intelligent. Again, the argument giving. Let's see, some animals, you can use them in field, etc. You can use them for plowing, for transportation. If you love the animals so much, why do you overload them? And furthermore, the Indian statistics tells us that out of the population of cows, oxes, and bull, only 25% are productive. The remaining 75% are unproductive, either past the age of milking or they are males, all done females, bulls, oxes. Now, what will you do with the 75% of excess non-productive cow, goat, bulls, ox? One option, you rear them up yourself. An average bull or cow requires 18,000 a year for living, according to the statistics. Their statistics, not my statistics. 18,000 a year. So after they give milk, they live another 4-5 years. Which farmer will bear the burden of millions of cow every year, 18,000? Second option is give to give their organization. They leave it open, it enters the field, eats up the crop. Third option, leave them in the jungle, animal will kill them. The last option is best, after they reach the age of milking, utilize the milk, give it to slaughterhouses, it benefits the farmer, he gets some money, and even the animal benefits the human being by eating the meat of the animal, as well as his hide for leather, as well as the bones. Hope that answers the question.
Next question for Mr. Zaveri.
According to Kasturi Chand Jain, in the marriage of the 22nd Tirthankar, Aris Nemi, popularly known as Neminath, meat of animals and birds was served. And both the bride and the bridegroom, according to Shastra, were Jains. Another incident was quoted that Chenna, a Jain Shravika who was the wife of Bhimsar Shrenik, a contemporary of Mahavir, was pregnant. And she had the desire to eat the heart of her husband. Bhimsar's eldest son, Abhay Kumar, instead gave her some meat of a dead animal, and Chenna, thinking it to be her husband's heart, ate it. I don't know how authentic is this article, and whether what Kasturi Chand said is true or false. What is its explanation? Please explain. I'm referring to the article from the Caravan series, December 1981.
Thank you, sister. First of all, I will request the coordinator to only allow those questions coming out of my talk, not out of any other book or another references for which I am not responsible. But because I am a true Jain, I know definitely about the Jain history, about Neminath Tirthankar. Yes, it is true. That is why he propagated that the killing of, that is exactly why he renounced the world, that for my marriage, are you going to sacrifice all these innocent creatures? No, I don't want such a feast for me. And that is why he became a Jain Muni and ultimately a Tirthankar. So that is why I can say that all Jain Tirthankaras have absolutely, in absolute terms, have prohibited non-veg food. Thank you. And please restrict your questions to my talk only, not because it seems, I don't know, it seems that these books were given in all good faith, that they should understand our viewpoint. It seems that they are all distributed to those people and they are now asked to ask questions. I don't think that is fair. You can ask me any question from my talk. I will be very happy to say
sir, that. I would like
and
to
I will request
any question can be asked on the topic. Well, the thing is there, whether it's in the talk or out
I don't
of the
mind,
of the
that
speakers,
is okay.
Not necessarily the
And another point I will tell any Mr. Coordinator that Mr. Y.P. Trivedi and myself, we both have got other meetings, so we would like to conclude within 5 minutes.
What I would suggest, see the time given to both the speakers to speak was 50-50 minutes, then 15 minutes was for response, then we would have a question answer session for 50 minutes. If any of the speakers would like to forfeit the time of not carrying on with the question session, if they have an emergency, I would excuse them, but I would continue the question answer session for 50 minutes because that has what been the chart given to me. I have to execute it like I had been told. Dr. Zakir cannot in his talk or response speak on any other religion. Forcefully got him not to speak on it. I'm telling you, forcefully I had to convince him you cannot touch anything else. I got him convinced because that was a request, his respect. Now, both what both speakers have agreed to, I have followed that. Anything which both speakers don't agree, I've thrown it out. Let me be very clear. We have said 50 minutes, we'll allow 50 minutes, but if one speaker would like to leave early for any emergency or any requirement, a person has got a full free will and a choice, I would respect that requirement, but we'll continue question answer for 50 minutes. I've written down the time, 12:45, close down at around 1:30, right? So I think that is being very fair and clear on my part. The next question for Dr. Zakir.
Assalamu alaikum, Zakir bhai. My name is Khan Abdul Sami, and my question to you is, food value charts are distributed by vegetarians showing that the proteins and iron content of vegetarian food is higher than non-veg food. And thus they say veg food is more nutritious then non-food. Your comments, please. Thank you.
The President asked a very good question. I would like to reply to the question posed by the learned speaker also. He doesn't know who distributed them. It is given in writing out here. It is given by Rishabh Foundation to IRF saying, we would be pleased to give you more such material in huge quantities if you like the same to be circulated among Muslim brothers in Mumbai. Free of charge, huh? The brother has asked a question that there are fruit charts being distributed. Yes, even we get in our foundation. We didn't respond, saying that it's not worth responding. It's not worth responding. But when the request came from the Rishabh Foundation, are you willing? I reluctantly agreed, you know, it is not a topic of scientific thing. It's a well-known fact. He said, yes, we'll debate. I said, fine. So I'm here, just replying. Why should people get irritated? If you can quote me from any book, as long as it's within the topic, I will, inshallah, answer. If I don't know, I will say I don't know. If I know, I will say no. I know your question. And when I got that chart, it gives food value chart, saying that protein among the veg food is more than non-veg food. And even Mr. Rashmi Azhaveri in his talk, he said that the value of proteins, the quantity is more. Mr. Rashmi Azhaveri said that there were only 3 essential amino acids. You ask any doctor, it is not 3, it is 8. No wonder 5 is lacking. It is 8 essential amino acids which are not synthesized in the body. The remaining are synthesized. These essential amino acids should be given by the external food source. The proteins of animal foods, the biologically complete, known as higher protein, because they contain all the 8 essential amino acids. The veg protein are lacking in one or more of the essential amino acids. It's a scientific answer. So even though the value may be more, 20 up, 10 down, it is not complete. The veg protein, the incomplete protein of lesser quality, animal protein is of higher quality and complete protein. Similarly, if you analyze, even the iron you get from the diet is of two types. One is heme iron, one is non-heme iron. Heme iron can be absorbed easily in the body. Non-heme iron cannot be absorbed easily. In the animal food, there is heme iron as well as non-heme iron. The vegetable food contains very little heme iron. Therefore, they cannot absorb. Therefore, there's more deficiency of iron in them. So even I agree with you, the iron content in figures may be high. The protein content may be higher. Now the conclusion is, veg food is more nutritive. It's misleading the people. It's nothing but misleading. I would call it in plain English, fraud. Who's doing it? Some vegetarian society. Misleading the people. And fraud is prohibited in every religion, small or big. Whether major or minor religion, fraud is prohibited.
Please.
I'm always prepared. I'm always prepared when I quote scriptures. Therefore, it's not on the table, it's inside. I wasn't supposed to quote unless compelled otherwise. Now they're compelling me to answer. Therefore, I kept it behind. Otherwise, my books are in the front always. They're compelling me to reply, therefore I'm replying. It's within the rules of the debate. I haven't completed it. I have to speak for 5 minutes. What?
We would request anyone not to disturb in between.
Yes, please don't disturb.
The question.
And we'll again, who's disturbing? See,
we'll allow another 20 seconds, you know, because this wastes time, you know, and then my time is up, I will stop the speaker.
No, but someone disturbs me, I should get more time.
Okay, we get. Complete the answer in 30 seconds.
It's further mentioned in the Manusmriti, chapter number 5, verse number 35, you can have meat. In Rig Ved, book number 10, hymn number 16, verse number 10, you can have meat. Rig Ved, book number 10, hymn number 85, verse number 13, Rig Ved, book number 10, hymn number 86, verse number 13. Says the same thing. You can have meat in Mahabharat, Anushasan Parv, chapter 88. If you read, Bhishma gives the advice to Yudhishthir. It's also mentioned in Manusmriti, chapter number 3, verse number 256 to 272. It's mentioned there that if you want to please your ancestors, if you give herbs and shrubs, you will gratify them only for 1 month. If you give fish, for 2 months. If you give venison, the flesh of deer, for 3 months. If you give mutton, for 4 months.
if you give flesh of bird for 5 months, if you give goat meat for 6 months, if you give spotted deer for 7 months, if you give meat of black antelope for 8 months, if you give cow 1 full year, if you give bull it is 12 years, and if you give rhinoceros and red meat of goat forever, inexhaustible. So if you have to satisfy your ancestors, according to Rig Veda, you have to give more, you have to give red meat.
Assalamu alaikum. My name is Gulfam, and this question goes to Mr. Zaveri. Sir, in your dialogue, you said, Jain Munis don't kill plants, they ask for alms. So is it that they force others to kill plants for them? Or is it that when they put masks on their face, they are not killing the germs and others are killing the germs by not putting the mask on the face? What is it? Please clarify.
It's a very good question, sister. I am really very happy. Of all the questions, I would definitely give you first number, because it is said in Jain religion that you should not kill anybody, you should not allow anybody to kill, and you should not appreciate if one kills. So all these three things are there. So if a Jain Muni comes to know that this food is prepared for him, he will not take it. So this is the rule of Jain Muni. When they come to us for begging, they ask us very clearly, we also know that they will ask us, have you prepared anything for us? We have to very honestly say, we have not prepared anything, it is for us. We have prepared, say, 4 chapatis, he will take only 1, we will be happy with 3. This is the way of begging of a Jain Muni. He will not kill, he will not allow others to kill, he will not propagate killing, he will not even eat if he comes to know that this food is prepared for a Jain Muni. I am happy that in this August and enlightened audience, I have been given an opportunity to clear the viewpoints of Jain Muni. Thank you very much. And I will now request the coordinator Mr. Trivedi and myself. It is really going on so nicely that we would like to continue here for hours together. But I am sorry that time constraint is such.
Last 2 questions will allow 5 minutes left.
I don't think it will be.
I think we have been talking so much about vegetarian food and non-vegetarian food, but we are all hungry now. I think we should go and eat. So only last 2 questions and then we disperse.
Mr. Trivedi has said we'll allow last 2 questions on the mic. When can we have the next question for Dr. Zakir? Yes? Acha, there's a request for Mr. For you want to ask question too? No. But they should have to follow. But I think you should have come up in the queue, you know.
Assalamu alaikum. My question for Zakir bhai is, are non-vegetarian food deficient in
nutrients? There is a request from the other speaker. What we will do, but there is a request from the side, allow 1 or 2 people to ask questions to Dr. Zakir. What I would suggest, let the speakers, in the time they are available here, let the other 2 speakers ask question. Then Mr. Trivedi and Mr. Zaveri can leave. Then I will give the chance so that I'm not unfair to you also, both people. So that, no, I've told them they wanted to leave, so I have to give them an opportunity to leave. They wanted those 2 people to ask questions. They can ask Dr. Zakir. Which are the 2 people, Mr. Zaveri? Mr. Bade and aap dono ko chance de denge. Then after that, we will carry on. The other 2 people will be given chance so that I'm not unfair to them. I hope the audience bears with me. For another 10, Mr. Trivedi and Mr. Zaveri would like to leave after that. So let those 2 people ask question. Acha, we'll allow only... No.
No. He is leaving. Let us ask 2 questions to him and let him hear.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, let us also ask a question.
Okay. Okay. Yes, let those 2 people ask question which Mr. Zaveri has requested. Mr. Bade, who's Mr. Bade? Acha, one Mr. Bade and that...
Rule.
Acha, and the other 2, they 2, acha, we'll allow them to ask 2 questions to one
by. To Dr. Hussain.
Excuse me, Mr. Zaveri. Okay, now question for. One question he'll ask, one you'll ask. Then I will allow Mr. Zaveri, after you all have finished your two questions, and one minute. After they have finished their two questions, you have finished your two, I'll allow them to leave. Then the other two who have missed their chance will be given permission. Beyond that, those who are missing because of these two people will be given a chance. Beyond that, I will not allow. Please, we have to complete the program. Yes, sir.
And salam alaikum.
May I have short, brief and to the point?
Dr. Saab.
Sir?
Dr. Saab.
Brief. Kishori, sir?
Yes.
Brief and to the point.
My question is this. I went to see the picture, Khane Khuda. There was a session of 3 days. So people, Haji Saab, they were wearing sandalwoods. And then besides that, not eating any as a non-meat food. No haircut, nothing, a complete brahmachari or sannyasi. Second. When the picture was over, I asked them, what is this? Those 3 days, complete renunciation, sannyasi, brahmachari, what reply they gave? He said, khane khuda tha. Maine kaha, Musliman bhaiyo, sara sansar khane khuda nahi hai. Wohi khane khuda hai.
Bhai sahab, 3 din aap rakhte ho. Bhai sahab, se question dara. Bhai sahab, hamare chief guest ko aur hamare speaker ko jana. Please put forward your question.
Sara sansar khane khuda hai. Please reply to me that those 3 days they were offering is khane khuda. What about the whole world is khane khuda? Why this killing should not be stopped everywhere, especially in India? This is mess.
So we will not allow that question. Sir, on the request of the chief guest and the speaker, we will not allow that answer. May we have the...
Mr. Rashmibhai Zaveri requested the person to ask a question out of turn. I am willing to answer. I am willing to answer. If chairman says no, then I will. I would love to answer if you allow me. Okay. Anyway, I will control the order. Nothing will go wrong.
Okay, we'll allow him, but a short this thing. What was the question? I didn't hear it.
I heard the question. I'm supposed to answer. It's a very good question.
Okay, now quickly and a quick answer, then we'll allow the other gentleman.
It's a very good question.
Yes.
It's a very good question. It will not create problems. I believe though you all are vegetarians out here, we aren't that violent. It won't create problems, I take guarantee. I will not say something that will create violence. Yes, I know there are non-veg and veg meats in Ahmedabad and Gujarat and there were riots and all here. As far as I'm concerned, I speak logical, then nothing happened. No, but I asked a very good question. He said that he had seen pilgrims going and for 3 days, they didn't have meat. They didn't have meat. It's on Islam. It's on Islam.
Why Islam allows like this? No, he's asked a question.
He's asking a question on Islam. He's not asking on Jainism. What's the problem? Are you so much afraid that the answer will make him a non-veg? He will yet be a veg. No problem. I don't want you to become a non-veg. The brother asked a very good question, that why there don't you have non-veg? It's a misinformation. I've been for Hajj several times. Whoever told you a lie that we don't have non-veg. The rule out there is that in that sacred part, at that time, you cannot kill any animal for hunting. At that time only. But not eating non-veg. I have gone there. I eat non-veg. Who says you can't eat non-veg? Yes, we are dressed up in 2 pieces of unsewn cloth. You know why? You know why? Because it's the biggest annual gathering in the world. People come from America, from Canada, from India, from Pakistan, from Indonesia, all dressed up in 2 pieces of unsewn cloth. Identical. You cannot make out the person next to you whether he's a king or a pauper. For universal brotherhood. Not theoretical, practical. Universal brotherhood. When we offer salah shoulder to shoulder. We eat food, we eat together. We eat even non-veg. Where you got this from, I don't know. Whoever told you, whether Muslim or non-Muslim, he has told you total falsehood. I'm telling you. I've been for Hajj several times. I've been for Umrah. It's totally wrong. And for universal brotherhood, everyone comes there. So that you can make out people from various parts of the world. We have to be one brotherhood. Islamic brotherhood is that all human beings are brothers. And Muslims are brothers in faith.
Yes, brother.
Mr. Zaveri, this question is for you. At the end of your speech, Mr. Zaveri, this question is for you, please.
Yes, put forward your question.
Mr. Zaveri is having his attention there. Mr. Zaveri, this question is for you. At the end of your speech, you have listed 16 points differentiating between the herbivorous animals and the carnivorous animals. Now, I don't feel there is anyone in the audience to know these differences, except that you want to give emphasis on the point that giving the comparisons of herbivorous animals, you want to reflect that we humans should also be herbivorous. That is, we should be vegetarian. This is what I understand. Dr. Zakir has already touched a few of the points. Now, Dr. Zakir and Mr. Zaveri, I'm not a medical student by profession. I'm an engineering student. I had biology only up to my 10th standard, and thereafter only I had gathered some knowledge from here and there.
Ask your question, please.
Question.
Now, here are the points which I want to get a comment from your side is that you have said that pitalin is there in the saliva of the herbivorous animal. It is there in the carnivorous animals, and it is there present in the humans also. Now, you have said that herbivorous animals rotate their jaws while eating. I have never seen a man rotating his jaws.
It's a question of your, if you want to put a question, you are most welcome. It's not a lecture
your
session.
Question, just
we are not here to hear your impressions. You are most welcome to ask me a question. Ask me a direct question, I'll be too willing to give you a reply.
Mr.
Trivedi and myself, we have got other appointments, we'll be leaving after this.
You ask your question in 3 to 4 sentences, that's all. Three to four sentences.
What was the need for you to give the differentiation between herbivorous and carnivorous animals? What do you want to emphasize?
Yeah, it is a very natural thing that when I stated that almost all limbs and parts of the body of a human being are very similar to herbivorous animals, it is for the enlightened audience to decide whether you agree with me or not. If you agree, it's well and good. Otherwise, if you don't agree, then also well and good. Who am I to say that you must agree on one point or others? That's okay. Because what I have stated is a scientific fact, which I have got reasons and I have got proof for that. But it is for the audience to see whether it is you are agreeable to that or not. My only point was that by nature, a human being is not only more, but 100% he is a herbivorous, and by certain circumstances or by some other reasons, he has been made a carnivorous. Now, friends, I must tell you that I'm extremely delighted to be here this morning and sharing our views. And so many misconceptions about Islam is now cleared by our learned Dr. Zakir. We never knew that these things are said in Islam. And for that, I'm extremely thankful to Islam Research Foundation, and I am also thankful to my friend Mr. Salecha Rushabh Foundation. And because of the time constraint of Mr. Trivedi and myself, because we have got other engagements, we will take your leave. And again, thank you very much.
Mr. Bade has to ask. Yes, you are Mr. Bade? Yes. No. Well, excuse me. Mr. Bade has been requested specially to be given a chance to ask question. We have honored that request, and he will be given a chance now. After that, Mr. Trivedi, the last question from that side. And then, yes, last question from there. Ladies, I think, are less in number, so we disallow those two questions which were missed out. I hope that would be fair, Mr. Trivedi. Yes, Mr. Bade, then you, and then we finish the session. Yes, Mr.
Hari Om to Hindus.
After we conclude the session, two people will get a chance to hear Dr. Zakir. If you want to hear the answer, and those who want to hear can stay back, others can go. Yes, Mr. Bade.
Hari Om to Hindus, Jai Jinendra to Jains, Salaam Walekum to Muslim Bhai.
Walekum Assalam.
Request to Dr. Zakir, I have all the answers of all your 20 questions, but that will not allow. Kindly give me a chance. Any time, you will get the logical answers of all the 20 questions, number one. Now, all the religions that follow the God is almighty. Now, that means one should follow his rules also. Now, what is given by the God, the rules formed up by the God? Ek seedhi si baat hai, ki jab Bhagwan ne hamein janam diya hai, toh unhone humare liye kuch vyavastha bhi ki. I would apply the same rule to the last speaker.
1 minute. Put your question in 5 sentences. Assume Dr. Zakir and Mr. Zaveri know the background. Ask your question. Six sentences, please.
I'm asking you the question only. तो भगवान ने हमारे लिए जो भी कुछ दिया है उन्होंने कुछ रूल फॉर्म करके दिए है, जैसे कि हमारे लिए सबसे इसेंशियल बात है हवा की, प्लेंटी ऑफ हवा इज अवेलेबल, अबंडेंट हवा इज अवेलेबल, उसके बाद पानी रहता है, पानी वेयर योर यू को पानी इज अवेलेबल. नाउ अदर थिंग इज फूड, व्हिच इज व्हिच आई एम कमिंग टू द क्वेश्चन. द फूड भगवान हैज गिवन अस द फूड आल्सो. कश्मीर में है हमारे लिए, कश्मीर में है इलाके के मुताबिक दिया है, कश्मीर में है हमारे लिए आलमंड्स दिए है, काजू दिए है, बादाम दिए है, पिस्ते दिए है, जहाँ के वहाँ जरूरी है. वन सेकंड, राजस्थान में जाओ आपको वहाँ वो टेम्परेचर के मुताबिक आपको खरबूजा मिलेगा, तरबूजा मिलेगा. यहाँ हमारे लिए वन सेकंड क्वेश्चन आई एम टेलिंग यू, यहाँ हमारे लिए हलवा बना के केले पे ऊपर रख दिया और वॉट एवर इजीली इज अवेलेबल ही हैज गिवन इज प्लेंटी. नाउ द वॉट एवर ही हैज गिवन इज प्लेंटी इज चीपर, एंड वॉट एवर ही सेज नो इट इज नॉट टू बी टेकन और इट इज रिस्ट्रिक्टेड शुड बी he has made it costly. So are we following the rule of the God?
Sir, what very is your question good. On this topic?
Very
he
good.
Understood. Okay.
Very, I've understood the question. Very long question. Very good question. See, I'm in the field. I can make out the question. I'm in the field. Regarding your first part, that you can answer all 20 points. I've got various students in this field. I'll ask one of my students to have a dialogue at IRF. If you want, any time, which date? Next Sunday. Next Sunday. Not me, my student. Next Sunday.
I can answer to anybody.
Next Sunday.
Anybody.
Next Sunday.
Anybody.
Okay, done. Next Sunday you're invited. What's your name? Mr. Brother, your name?
Everything will be given.
Mr. Bade will come to IRF at 10:30. Fine. 10:30 morning. Fine. Sunday. Fine. Same format here, and my student will debate. Anyone? Same topic. His question, that God has provided air, right, water, everything easily available. So why go for things which are uneasily available and costly? Very good question. That you have to point out to Mr. Zaveri. He is telling that vegetables should be transported to Arctic Circle. Vegetables should be transported to deserts. Tell him, I didn't say that. I'm saying if vegetable is available, have vegetable. If animal is available, have the lawful animal. You have to pose that question to him, not to me. Point number one. You should have easily available food as long as it is lawful. We should have expensive food, you told me. It's like I telling a rich person, why are you living in Nariman Point? You know, 1 square feet of land, apartment, Nariman Point, costs 25,000 rupees. Come to Mira Road, only 1,000 rupees per square feet. When the rich man can afford to pay money to buy a good flat, why are you preventing a rich man to buy good food? And non-veg food, in protein, in iron, in various ways, medically, it is superior, it's of higher quality. So if rich man can afford it, why are you stopping? If you can't afford, have vegetables. I'm not stopping you. Hope that answers the question.
Thank you for your enthusiasm. We'll not allow that question. Mr. Zaveri said he would like to, he's exhausted, and we respect his views. He would like to leave, so we'll not allow that question, but we'll allow two people here who are to ask questions after Mr. Dhanraj Sarlecha would propose a vote of thanks, after which those who would like to leave may leave, those who would like to hear those two questions and two answers.
Question from the lady's side.
It's not working. Hello?
The meeting would be formally closed. Only two questions
hello.
After the meeting would be allowed.
Hello? Excuse me, this is one last question from the ladies. This is for Dr. Zakir.
After this, just two people and one from the ladies, no one else would be. Four questions.
Hello?
Mr. Tarvedi is saying I should be strict. Now the thing is that I am being compassionate. I give chance to two people here. Now everyone is demanding of it. What we allow? Vote of thanks right away. Then four questions. Two here, one there, then close. That's final. Yes, Mr. Dhanraj Sarlecha to propose a vote of thanks.
Chief guest, Sri YP Trivedi, learned speakers of dialogue, distinguished guests, brothers and sisters. It's really my pleasant duty to offer vote of thanks on behalf of all the three organizations on whose behalf, I thank Sri YP Trivedi to spare his valuable time and grace this occasion as chief guest. I am really thankful to both the speakers for their most interesting and informative discussion, and above all, I thank you all the participants for participating in the debate. Thank you.
Now we continue on with the four questions. The chief guest, Mr. Trivedi, Zaveri, are excused. Those who would like to hear the three or four questions aloud may sit back. We will continue in a minute as the chief guest and the speaker leave. The formal program is closed. We will have an informal four questions allowed for the audiences, for the four questioners who didn't get a chance because of my interfering and giving the other speaker the chance. Ladies and gentlemen, your attention please. We are starting the sequel question answer session right away. Yes, brother.
My question is, are non-vegetarian food deficient in nutrition?
The brother has asked a very good question. That are non-vegetarian food deficient in any nutrient? Yes, they are. It would be wrong on my part to say no. I'm not a fanatic non-vegetarian. It's deficient in carbohydrate, vitamin C, but this is easily available in vegetables. Non-vegetarian vegetables and fruits, they are rich in vitamin C. We can have fruits. But as a normal comparison, a nutritive value, if you analyze the non-veg food, as I mentioned earlier, it contains first-class proteins, high quality, and complete protein. Contains essential fatty acids, even iron, and one of the good foods is egg, which the speaker spoke so much against egg. The egg contains about 6 grams of protein, one large egg. The half of it is the egg white, and the egg white is known as an ideal protein. Ideal protein means a protein by which other proteins are judged. It contains all the essential amino acids in the right quantity. Egg also contains riboflavin, iron, folate, vitamin B12, vitamin D, vitamin E. One of the few only foods which contains vitamin D is egg. Egg is given to people who are sick and are convalescing, who are improving from sickness. You know why? It's easily digested, contains all the requirement. Spoke so much about egg, it has little negative factors also. It's also called a nutrient-dense food because it contains all the essential nutrients in the right quantity without excess of any one particular substance and contains less calorie. Contains 70 calories only, one large egg. But there are many foods which contain essentials, amino acids, which are not there in the veg food. In the veg food, what we have to do, if we require all the nutrients, a person can be a veg and get the nutrients how? By selecting the particular diet, by selecting the vegetables eating. If this vegetable is deficient in one amino acid, have the other vegetable which has it. So if he selectively chooses in the correct balance and monitors it, then he'll be healthy. In non-veg food, just have a non-veg food, and normally you won't be deficient in these nutrients. Hope that answers the question.
Yes, brother.
My name is Babubhai Jhaveri. Dr. Zakir Naik mentioned in his speech, he tried to quote authorities, alternative to Dr. Dean Arnish. Dr. Dean Arnish has been a pioneer in the field of research on reversal of heart diseases, and he has now come to be acclaimed as an authority. His contribution to the field has been recognized by the President of the United States by appointing him as an advisor to advise Americans on health matters. It is at the instance of Dr. Arnish that now it has been incorporated in the authoritative medical textbooks that heart disease can be reversed through the diet which has been practiced and preached by Dr. Arnish. And this particular diet consists exclusively of vegetarian food. Now, I would like to know from Dr. Zakir Naik, when he has quoted alternative authorities, what he has to say about Dr. Dean Arnish's research, which has cured thousands of patients of coronary disease without bypass surgery.
Brother asked a very good question, very relevant question, to the point. that what do I have to speak about Dr. Arnish, who's very famous? And he has said that the heart disease can be reversed by food which is only vegetarian food. I agree. Does it make non-veg food prohibited? Do you know diabetes mellitus? Brother, diabetes mellitus, you don't require Dr. Ornish to say if a person is suffering from diabetes, severe diabetes mellitus, if he doesn't take non-veg treatment of insulin produced by bovine, by pancreas of cow or of pig or human being, he will die. So if a non-veg food can cure diabetes mellitus, that doesn't make veg food prohibited. I agree with Dr. Ornish. It proves that heart diseases can be prevented or cured by veg diet. I agree. But what Mr. Rashmibai Zaveri said, Dr. Ornish said, it should be prohibited as a general rule. For heart patient, I agree. People may differ. Many doctors may differ. I agree. But to say because it cures heart disease, non-veg should be prohibited as a general rule, then why isn't America banning non-veg food? Advisor to American government, why doesn't the government take the advice of Dr. Ornish and stop non-veg food? Why? What his research is, if he's authority, he's right. But to quote authority and then say he banned it, I doubt whether Dr. Ornish ever banned it. I doubt. I have my doubts. Show me the statement where he says that no human being ever in this life should have any non-veg food. I challenge you. He may say heart patients. There are other authorities I quoted. Dr. William T. Jarvis, Dr. K. Jerry, several. But I am more pragmatic. I agree with him. It's helpful in curing heart disease, not as a general rule. Hope that answers the question. I'm very clear.
Yes, sister.
This is regarding, since Dr. Zakir is a scientist and a doctor himself, so I would like him to enlighten me on the 15 years of clinical trial on...
I didn't get the question, sir. Can you repeat the question?
15 years of clinical trial at the National Cancer Research Institute at Maryland in USA on this red meat. Red meat causes cancer and all those things. Is it possible for him to enlighten me on this? Thank you.
It's a very good question. Sister said out of 15 years of research in some cancer hospital. Research, again, not fact. There's a difference between research and fact. But I agree with that research also. I've read that research. Whether from cancer hospital or which hospital which she's referring to, I've read several research that it does cause cancer of the colon. Excessive eating of non-veg causes cancer of colon if it doesn't contain diet rich in fiber. If the diet is rich in fiber, however much meat you have, it will not cause cancer. If it's combined with excessive eating of non-veg and lack of fibrous diet, you know, veg food you eat, it can't be digested because the cellulose can't be digested. It remains as fibers, which helps in the motility. Excessive eating of non-veg with not eating fibrous diet causes cancer of colon. But if you have the proper combination, everyone having red meat doesn't have cancer. Excessive eating, Quran says it is haram. So they are going against the Quran. They are bound to get diseased. That doesn't mean non-veg should be prohibited. It should be said, excessive eating of non-veg should be prohibited. Hope that answers the question. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillah rabbil alamin.
Thank you very much. Jazakallah khairan for being here today and sharing your Sunday morning with us. Inshallah.